models, that is exponential growth model and logistic growth model. And in this class, we will start with life history variations, and that is explained by Darwin. And we started explaining some for you the different rules about organisms, about evolution. Okay, and one of that is Darwin's fitness, that is survival of the fittest. Okay, here he explains population can evolve to maximize to reproductive fitness to max in their habitat. Okay, means how populations, why populations are grow and why they are going to survive, because the reproduction, because for the purpose of reproduction, and they can survive in their natural habitat and they will struggle in that natural habitat. Okay, and that is by explains about variations. Okay, they are varying in the reproductive structures. Okay, that means for example, organisms can reproduce. Some organisms can reproduce. Some organisms can reproduce once in their lifetime. Okay, some organisms can reproduce once in their lifetime. Only one time in their lifetime they can reproduce. Okay, for example, you have put in you wheat plant. For example, jawar. Okay, for example, bamboo. These plants are examples for once in, they can reproduce once in their lifetime. Means wheat is going to flower in once in their lifetime. Okay. Fertilization takes place once in their lifetime, reproduction takes place, okay, and seeds are going to form, grains are going to form once in their lifetime. After that, their plant is going to die, okay. So, that is a once in their lifetime. Some organisms can reproduce many in their lifetime, many times, okay. One time in their lifetime, some are having many times in their lifetime. For example, mango. Mango can give fruits every in the summer season. Okay, that is regularly in a season that is going to flowering. Fertilization takes place, reproduction takes place, and after that, we are getting a fruit for every season. Okay, that is many times in their lifetime. Okay, human beings. Okay, then almost all mammals. They are going to reproduce many types, that is different reproductive variation, and some are new, some reproduces smaller in size but larger in number. Smaller in size but larger in number. Okay, smaller in size, larger in number means that is the size is small. For example, silk moth, frog. Okay, these organisms can give a 300 to 400 fish. Okay, fish. These organisms can give 300 to 400 legs. 300 to 400 eggs at a time. Okay, but the number is large, but the size. What about size of the body? That size is small. Okay, that is also reproductive variation. And one more, exactly opposite to this sentence. Okay, some organisms can smaller in number but larger in size. See here, some organisms can give smaller in number. Their number is small, but their size is large. For example, elephant. Elephant produce many times, but their size is a large, big size, and that give only one young one at a time. Okay, for example, human beings are like per day. Okay, human beings, that is also give one or two at a time, but their size is large, but their number is small. In this way, reproductive variations takes place. Okay, that is the that is what reproductive fitness. Okay, that comes in life history. interaction between two living species, that is between same species, that is between same species or between different species, that is between same species or between different species. Okay, that is the interaction. Both are interacted to each other. That is called population interaction. There are different interactions are given. That is first one, mutualism. Second one, parasitism. Third one, predation. Fourth one, competition. Fifth one, commensalism. Sixth one, amensalism. Commensalism, amensalism. There are different population interactions are given, and there are given a different example for these. Okay, and between two, these two species, one is benefited. Other one, sometimes both are benefited. Okay, sometimes both are benefited between different species. Okay, between species, sometimes one is benefited, both are benefited. Sometimes one is benefited, one is harmed. Okay, sometimes one is not harm and one is benefited. Sometimes both are harmed. Like these species are going to interact. Okay, that is benefited is represented as plus sign. Okay, and harm is represented as minus sign. Okay, and not harm or neutral, that is represented as zero. Like this, these are represented. And at last, we are discussing about which is benefited, which is harmed. Okay, at last, we are going to discuss about plus sign, minus sign. Okay, let's start with first examples of mutualism. First, we will start with the mutualism. Mutualism. Okay, what is mutualism? In a mutualism, both interacting species are benefited. Both interacting species are benefited. Okay, means if we take the example, okay, that is here actually mutualism is depends on common association and temporary association. Means what? If we take the example of flying, then we will discuss about permanent association and temporary association. Okay, if we take the example of lichens, see, I hope you heard this name lichen in first year. Okay, what are lichens? That is the association, that is the association of algae and fungi. That is the mutual association of algae and fungi is called lichen. Okay, see here, algae is going to permanent association. This is the permanent association of algae and fungi. Algae is going to provide food to the fungi, and fungi is going to provide water and shelter to the algae. Okay, from algae is going to produce algae is a or photosynthetic in nature because there is having photosynthetic pigments. But what about fungi? Fungi are the saprophytes. They cannot prepare their own food. They comes in heterotrophic. This is autotrophic. This is heterotrophic. So algae provides food to the fungi and fungi provides water and shelter to the algae. So both are mutually benefited. Both are benefited. But here this is a permanent association is there. Okay, they are not there after some time. They are not separated. They are always associated. So this type of association is called symbiosis. This type of association is called symbiosis. Okay, one more example that is we are giving. Which one is that? We are already referring. It is rhizobium bacteria. This is also symbiotic association. Okay, this rhizobium bacteria. This is the name of the bacteria. Okay, which is present in the root nodules of the leguminous plants. Okay, which can pollination. Okay, and what are the pollinators? And here in carbon is attractive in nature, and that is also having a sweet fluid that is called nectar for the, and that nectar is a nourish for that is nourishment for the honeybee. Honeybee gains nectar, nectar synthesis. Okay, so if this is a flower. Next example. One more is a hydrant, thorium. This is the type of inflorescence. Okay, type of inflorescence. What do you mean by inflorescence? Inflorescence, that is a cluster of flowers present on the stem. That is called inflorescence. And where cluster of flowers is there? That is hydrant, thorium. Example of that, that is ficus. What do you mean by that? It is called Atihanu. Atihanu. Atihanu is called figure ficus. What is it like? That is like this. See. I hope you all have seen it. Like this. Okay. That is having three types of flowers. Inside, when you break that fruit, then inside a small flowers are present. Once the yellow one you know, okay, and open my mouth, there are some flowers cut away. There are three types of flowers: male flowers, female flowers, and sterile flowers. Three types of flowers: male flowers, female flowers, and sterile flowers. Okay, and here a wasp is going to enter. Okay, what is that name of the wasp? That is, the name of the wasp is gall wasp. Gall wasp. That name of the insect. Okay, that gall wasp is enters into the hypan. This is the name of the. This is the type of the hypanthodium. A group of flowers, here see so many flowers are present. This is a group of flowers, so it is an inflorescence. And what is that name of the inflorescence? Hypanthodium inflorescence. Okay, here a group of flowers are present. What type of flowers? Male flowers, female flowers, sterile flowers. When this wasp enters into the fig, then that can lay the eggs on the sterile flowers. Okay, these are the male flowers, like this, male and sterile flowers are like this. Okay, like this. And that lays eggs on the sterile flowers, and that feed on the sterile flowers only. And when these eggs are going to hatch and larva it comes out, this larva is also feeds on that sterile flower. Like this, that also helps in pollination. Okay, that also helps in pollination. Means that insect is going to feed on that flowers, and that helps in pollination. Means both are mutually benefited. Both are mutually benefited. Like this, there are different examples are given in the mutualism. Okay, there are, first we are explaining about association, that is permanent association and temporary association. That is, first example is lichen. Okay, second example, that is rhizobium. Third example, that is pollinators and plants. Then rhizobium and root nodules. Lichen. Fourth example, that is pseudopodial. Cheaters got that. Next one. Pseudo population and last one, that is hypanthodium. These are the different examples are given in the mutualism. Okay, they are already discussed. Let's start with the next one. Second one, which is the two species. Okay, one is earthworm. These are the different examples for endoparasites. Okay, this tapeworm is having two host body. Tapeworm is a very host body. That is, one is man and the host body is pig. Very host body of tapeworm present. One to manushan badaga, inondu pig badaga. Again, liver fluke is also having two bodies, two host bodies. One is man, okay, and another one is snail and fish. Okay, snail and fish means liver fluke is not to the one manushan body badaga. Second one na snail and fish body badaga. Even plasmodium is also having two bodies. That is, one is man, another one is female. Anopheles. Female Anopheles. Okay, and this Ascaris is present in only man intestine. Ascaris is the man intestine. Means these endoparasites are like these harmful in nature, and these are present in two host bodies. Okay. And for surviving in the host body, they are having some adaptations. Okay, they are having some adaptations to survive in the body. I mean, right, they are having adaptations. What are the adaptations? Okay, adaptations means they are having some different organs which are helping to survive in that host body. They are having thick cuticle on the body. Cuticle means a covering. Okay, they are covered by a thick cuticle. Why? Because against our enzymes. Okay, in our body enzymes is present, and in our body HCl acid is present. Against the protection of our enzymes and HCl, that they are having a thick cuticle on the body. Okay, second one, they are having hook like structures to entangle into the in host body. Host body la vadu kekara undi attach aagutada, attach aagutada adike en kadaguthada hook like structure kadaguthada. They are having a hooks. Okay, next they are having digestive system is absent. Digestive system is upset. Why? Because they are getting what? Ready-made food from the body. Okay, body, host body, the ready-made food is sick. But they get digestive system. So digestive system is upset. Fourth one, okay. Sense organs are upset. Sense organs are upset. Sense organs are the host body. Because they are moved with the help of blood. Blood in the one place, in another place, it move up the way. They need not what? Sense organs like us. Okay, next one. At last, they are having well reproductive structure. Because for the reproduction to continue the generation, they are having a well reproductive structure. Like this, they are having some adaptation present in the host body. Okay, that is about endoparasites. Next, we will explain about exoparasites. Okay, exoparasites. And exoparasites, they are also present outside the host body. Example, you have to say, leech is an exoparasite. Second example, lice is an exoparasite. Okay, and next example, there are different examples, ticks. These are the exoparasites which are present outside the body, but they feed on the host blood. Okay, host body blood name on the way, feed on the way. Okay, and for that also they are having some adaptations. It means exoparasites also having some adaptations. What is that adaptation? They are having suckers for sucking blood from the host body. Okay, they are having what? Suckers ಎರಡು ಸೈಡ್ ಸಿಕ್ಕ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. We are having two suckers, okay, and these visited suckers that helps him to suck the blood from the host body. So this is the adaptation in the exoparasite. And one more information here, anopheles. See here, mosquito is not a parasite.
Some examples of